Well, Jean, students are taking the message seriously, and they're making sure that they keep up to date with everything that's going on. But those we talked to today say that they're really not too worried about it. They say some of their friends have already gotten sick and were back to class in a matter of days, and that really has set their minds at ease.
Just 2 weeks into the school year, and it's confirmed. The H1N1 flu virus is on the Dartmouth College campus.
I think the one thing that's a little surprising is that it started as early as it did. And it just makes us realize that this whole concept of this, the influenza season has been changed.
Dr. Jack Turco says 175 students have come down with flu-like symptoms. And while tests are not done on all students, they have sent some samples to the state.
You know, we've sent about a dozen or 12 or 14 of them, and about two out of three have been positive.
He says cases have been mild, with students coming back to class in 3 to 4 days. But it has caused a spike in calls to health services, and routine health visits have been cut back or in some cases eliminated.
We just want to make sure we have enough, people power to answer the phones, to talk to individuals. And I think most of the students and the faculty that we've talked to are very understanding. They realize, I don't think they're freaked out by the fact that H1N1 is causing illness.
I'm not, afraid of it or anything.
These friends say they just try to wash their hands frequently and stay away from those who are sick.
I don't think it's any worse than, the regular flu. I just think it's a lot easier to get.
I don't think that, we should really be changing, anything, at this point at least, dramatically about the way that we sort of live our lives here at the college.
These guys admit they didn't waste any time getting the flu shot this year, but they feel confident in the college's proactive approach.
I really think if we really pay a lot of attention to good hygiene, take voluntary isolation seriously, we can minimize the number of people that will, contract the disease.
Now, the campus health director says while it is recommended that anyone who is sick wear a mask if they have to interact with people, he says that it is not necessary for everyone on campus to do so. And, of course, he is pushing the message of washing your hands. Reporting live from the Dartmouth College campus, Heather Hamill, WMUR News 9.